bin misal metmuşta idin al mehtin ve alem al mutekim alel emyay salihin ve ila meşayikına bi tarikatın akşiben niyetil aliyye qaddes allahu teala ermam zekiyen münevver allahu teala zatel mereke ve ala allahu teala nem berekatim ve fidatim daimen velhamdülillahi rabbil alemin.
Fatiha. Subhane rabbiyel
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Allahumme salli ve sellim ve barik aleyhi ve ala alihi ve sahbihi ve sellim. Elhamdülillahi rabbil alemin. Allahumme salli ve sellim ve barik aleyhi ve ala alihi ve sahbihi ecmain. Canan Allahu iyyana ve iyyakum men yestecibu şefaata ve yercu min Allahi rahmeti ve rafata. Allahumme bi hurmeti hazen nebiyyin kerim ve alihi ve sahbihi men hacin kavim. İcalna min kıyari ümmeti ve aslamina min zeyni hurmeti. Haşurna gadan fi zumrati ve aslamin elsenetin afimati ve nusrati. Kadina mutemessikine bi sünneti ve taati. ومتنا اللهم على هبي وجماعتي اللهم ادخلنا مع الجنة فإنه أول من ينزلها وارحمنا يوم يشفى الخلائق فترحمها اللهم زدنا زيارته في كل سنة ولا تجعلنا من الغافلين أنك ولهم قبل السنة اللهم لا تجعلنا في مجلسنا أهدا إلا غسلته بما توبتي أنزل بها وسكنت به بهداية المغفرة أيوبا اللهم إنه كان معنا في سنة مادية إخواننا معنا أنقذوا إلى بسم حسن هذا الليلة وفضله رحمهم الله اللهم ارحمنا إذا سرنا من أصحاب القبور وفقنا إلى عمل إنسان يبقى سنه على من زهور اللهم اجعلنا لأنائك الزاكرين ولإمائك الشاكرين وليوم لقائك الزاكرين وإلى بطاعتك المشغولين وإذا توفيتنا فتوفى غير مفتونين ولا محزونين أقدم لنا خيرهم أجمعين اللهم اكفنا شر الظالمين اللهم اكفنا شر الظالمين اللهم اكفنا شر الظالمين واجعلنا من فتنة هذه الدنيا سالمين اللهم اجعلنا هذا النبي شفيع يرزقنا به يوم القيامة مقاما رفيعا اللهم اسقنا من حوض نبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم شربة هنية منية نالت ما بعده أبدا تحت لوائه غدا اللهم ارحم لأبائنا ولأمهاتنا ولمشايخنا ارزقك علينا وزد أجر هذا الخير في هذه الليلة ولجميع المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك أنت قريب مجيب الدعوات وقاضي الحاجات وقاضي الحاجات وقاضي الحاجات واغفر الذنوب والخطيئات يا أرحم الراحمين يا أرحم الراحمين يا أرحم الراحمين وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم سبحانك ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين
إلى آخر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى أصحابه الكرام والمشايخ من تلك الأصالقة شعب الدين محمد الأبيس البخاري سلطان الأولياء شيخ عبد الله فوز الدستاني صاحب الزمان شيخ الإمام محمد ناظم الحقاني عبد الخالق الجواني Sayın Sadatına ve Sıddık'ın Hazirin el-Gaybine Fatiha. Fatiha. Amin. Selamun Aleyküm. Rahmetullah ve berekatuhu. Welcome to you. Okay. How are you, John?
Fine.
Welcome to you. Anybody has anything to say? Any question anybody has? Ali. First, starting with the obligation. Fars. What is fars to do? Is only prayers are fars? Okay. And most important thing, to run away from the forbidden actions. When a man is committing the wrongdoing, the forbidden action means the harams, or the megruh. The Holy Prophet did not advise for us to do. While the man is running to do the forbidden action, that time, even that, the faith is not in the heart. Faith comes out from the heart. When you are running to do what Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forbid us, what is haram? What is haram and what is halal? So when the man is running to do the haram action, the faith and the haram cannot stay in the same heart. It's not possible. So the faith comes out, circling on top of your head, until you come to realization that you did wrong and you regret and you ask forgiveness, then the faith comes inside that time. During that time, faith is not in your heart, so you are not a believer. If you die during that time, you lose everything. Whatever you did, as Holy Prophet saying, alayhi salatu wasalam, haram and forbidden action cannot be in the same heart where the faith is. The faith comes out and you run to do that wrong action. Until you realize and you ask forgiveness, the faith doesn't come back in. And if you die during that time, Holy Prophet saying, alayhi salatu wasalam, if the angel of death will reach to you, you'll die as a jahiliya death, meaning unbeliever. This nation of Muhammad became so brave, running to do every haram that is forbidden. Shaitan is fooling, saying, it's okay. You know, you can do. You cannot do. You cannot do as a believer. You do it as a unbeliever. You will do that action, that wrong action, that forbidden action, as a unbeliever. You cannot do as a believer. It's not accepted. So if you want to increase your faith, you mean, that's what you are saying. To increase the faith. Yes. That's what the man should be busy with. To increasing the level of the faith. Are you knowing, understanding which level is in it? Are you questioning yourself to say, the level of the faith I have now, is it okay? Do I pass? If the angel of death is coming to me, do I pass? Or you just fool yourself? If you do, anyway, there will be so many signs appear in front of you that time. So the most important is every day, what is it that we're doing? Every do that Allah has ordered to us to do, every order that He forbid us not to do, what it does is just increases the faith, supports the faith, and builds the faith up. And depending which level of your faith when the angel of death is coming to you. Now, if he's on the zero level, which so many people today, they are fading the zero level. Just falling, just like the gauge of the car. There is no gas in it, it's empty. The engine is there, everything is there, but no gas. And the hitless man is sitting on the chair, holding the steering wheel, and saying, I'm going. Brum, brum, brum. I'm going. That's what happened today to children over them. They're fooling themselves with lies and cheatings. If the level of the faith is increasing, what Holy Prophet is saying, your today has to be better than yesterday. Your tomorrow must be better than today. Oh, we work today. Double shift. Instead of making 100, we make $300. Do you think your level of faith has reached higher station because you reach worldly to higher station? You can earn the world all day long. The whole world, you can earn it maybe. If you don't have the faith, there's no value. The angel of death coming to you, saying goodbye. Leave everything here and come out. He's not going to give you anything. Especially today's people. Today's people, they don't use it and they don't let others to use too. They don't eat and they don't let others to eat. They have not learned to share nothing anymore too. Because Shaitan is ordering, saying, be benjil, a selfish one. Think only to yourself, nothing else. The believer is that one who thinks the one that is front of him first. And Allah thinks of you that time. Where is that believer? You are looking. So, the whole key, whole secret is to make your faith to grow every day. Stronger and higher and bigger. And more your faith is going to grow, more you're going to come to realization of how much ghaflet you was in yesterday. And you're going to see what is standing in front of you. And that time you're going to try to run away from the tricks and the traps of this dunya, and you're going to run to say, I don't have too much time really to spend with the nonsense of this world. I have to keep myself busy with so much time that I have spent with nonsense. I have to keep myself busy to prepare myself to build my ahiret, to build my world that is waiting for me, eternal life, not the dunya. Why the people they are fighting in this dunya? Do you say one individual, do you show me one individual today that they are fighting? They are arguing with each other because one of them is progressing in the Ahiret road. Eh? And the other one is not, that's why they are fighting. Can you show me one individual like that in the world? Are you arguing? Everyone is arguing. Everyone is fighting with themselves, with each other. They're sitting next to each other. They are looking at each other, smiling. They are getting up, hugging each other, but they hate each other from the heart. Say that is not true. Say that is not true. How much you worrying about for your brother? If you don't see that one for 10 years, you don't care. As soon as you see, oh, how you doing? And that's it. Allah Allah. What kind of world I have fallen into? So selfish ones. Everyone forgets about everything. So easy and so simple. Because of the selfishness. Yes. Don't forget. Don't forget one thing. Don't forget what you did yesterday. And where are you going tomorrow? Don't forget. Forget what you did good for others. And what others did bad to you. Forget about that. But don't forget what you did to others. Don't forget that part. And run to fix it. There's another big sickness. Today Muslims. From where they're coming from? Is it from Islam? No. It's not from Islam. But the Muslims, they make themselves believe that it's from Islam. But it's not. They enter into Islam from kufr, from unbelievers. It's not even in the true Christianity. It's not in the true Judaism. Selfishness is not accepted. Who's selfish? Shaitan. Anyone is carrying that characteristic, carrying one another cigarette from Shaitan. Yes. You know how to fight when something you think that some rights is taking away from your hand. Are you also fighting for the rights of other people too? When their rights is taking away from their hand? Are you standing up? No. That's why the world is like this. Yes. Is that what Holy Prophet said, how the believers are? No. Holy Prophet saying, the believers, they are like one body. If the feet is hurting, the whole body is hurting. If the finger is hurting, the whole body is hurting. If the head is hurting, the whole body is hurting. If a believer is on the other side of the world, if he's hurting, the believer on the other side of the world should not be happy. Should not be enjoying, saying, enjoy your life. And this is another big sickness. This is also entered from unbelievers, from secularism, from unbelievers, saying, enjoy yourself. Enjoy your life. Enjoy. You are not in the world to enjoy your life. You are in the world to be a servant. Enjoyment is hereafter, not in this world. Those who pass the test, they will be enjoying the life after that. So, wrong things enter. They put, and so many coming to Islam with that sickness and they're not leaving that outside. So many is liking to themselves too, and became a mess. Is it in Islam? No, it's not in Islam. But they make it believe, they make it look like it is in Islam. But it's not. Islam is away from that. Islam, Holy Prophet came to teach and to show what is Islam is. Through his lifestyle. And he did. And he lived. And he passed from this world and he left the blueprint to us. Saying, if you live according to this, you will find peace. Blessings in dunya and akhirat. If you don't look to find peace in dunya, you're not going to find in akhirat too. That's what it is. But you want to fool yourself. If you are in that station anyway, the fear is not inside of you. The angel of death is going to come to me now. Because you already reached to that level that you cannot wait to pass from this world to go to the other world. Because this world, it is stinking every sight now. There is no trust to anything. People, they are betraying left and right 24 hours a day. People, they are betraying their own kinds. They are betraying their own children. They are betraying everything for what? For worldly benefits. It's nothing else. No one is betraying for the heavenly benefits. You cannot betray for heavenly benefits. You will give up from your egoistic actions. People, they are betraying everything left and right. And later preparing to say, I'm going to have better life tomorrow. What did you build today? And you're going to find tomorrow. Whatever you're building today, that's what you're going to find tomorrow in front of you. Saying, oh, Allah is helping you. Allah has helped you. Allah sent you His Prophet. Allah sent you His laws. Allah sent you what you have to do, what you should not to do. Allah sent you saying to you, now wake up, soon as you wake up, turn around and don't try to change anything. Run what Prophet left to you and hold on and change. Then I'll forgive you. Otherwise, everyone wants changes. Everyone is right according to their own head. The Christian world, 4 billion, 4 billion is thinking that they're all right. As of one unique one, but inside of them, they all separated hundreds of thousands of pieces. And inside of them, every individual, they are thinking that they are right. 4 billion thinking Jesus is God. MashaAllah. You couldn't even understand that yet. And you're going to reach somewhere. You don't even understand your Lord. And you think that you are living correct lifestyle on the face of earth. You don't know your Lord. You are thinking that the man is your Lord. And you think you're living correct lifestyle. To them, yes. Already they are speaking every day too with the God too. Yes. The Jews, same. The Muslims shouldn't be that way. But they became worse. Because everyone knows Allah and His Prophet. What do you know? How do you know? They come to Islam yesterday. They still fool with a mess. Today they're talking Sharia. This is Sharia to you. From where are you learning this? Who teaches you? Other than Shaitan. Yes. Shaitan saying, you are right. You cannot be wrong. Impossible. Because you left that and you're finding Allah and His Prophet now. So you are right. What do you know, Prophet? You know his name. You heard his name. How much do you know about the Prophet? And Allah. Say Allah. Allah, Allah, Allah, Allah, Allah. Making zikr. You are with Allah? No, you're just saying the name. Allah, Allah, Allah. Tongue saying, heart in so many other places. It's not making any progress. When you really start making the zikr, every cell of your body, when you are pulling, saying Allah, Allah, you feel that you will pull the whole world with you that time. Inside of you. The whole cells in your, inside your body start saying Allah. And you hear them. And you hear everything surrounding. That is the time you're making. You are making the zikr of Allah. You didn't reach to Allah yet. Game. Everyone making Allah and His Prophet's game. Learning so much. And saying, from where are you learning this? I just read Quran Kareem and I read and I understand Sharia. Hasbunallah wa ni'mal wakeel. Hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. That is tricks and traps from Shaitan. Yes. So, yes, you want to progress. You want to become a better servant.
every day you have to check what did you do wrong yesterday. And if you cannot find one wrong, that means everything you did is wrong. Yes. If you did everything right, the paradise has to open in front of you. As soon as you say Allahu Akbar, you're putting this dunya behind you. As soon as you say that, Allahu Akbar, you must be finding yourself front of Kaaba. Not front of that four wall. Front of that one who's leading the five daily prayer. You didn't even know about this. Yes. Where are we praying? Saying Allahu Akbar and heart off. Never thinking such a things, that is the time you start thinking. And you pray. Just taglit, copying the actions. And today's people, they're not even copying the actions right too. Majority doesn't even know how to read the Subhanaka. That's the truth. That is the truth. But again, those who doesn't know how to read Subhanaka, they are giving fatwa about Islam. Sharia, saying this is Sharia. This is accepted, this is not accepted. So, prepare yourself for a heavy test, because you will be questioned. Definitely you'll be questioned to say to you, from where did you hear this? Not only you, the whole awliyas, whole sheikhs, whole imams, they're going to be questioned. Saying you said this, all prophets, they're going to be questioned. All prophets, they're going to be questioned. And people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it will call Isa alayhi salam and saying to him, are you the one who said to these billions that you are my son and I'm your father? He's going to say, no, ya Rabbi, I didn't. And Allah will say to him, but you are one. And there is billions that they are saying that you said it. Do you have any witness? And that is the time Isa alayhi salam will say, yes, ya Rabbi, my witness is Muhammad alayhi salam and all those ones that who's in the awakening station, the nation of Muhammad. Not the hitless Muslims, the nation of Muhammad, they have understood the ayats in the Quran Kareem and they follow according and they live according to that. They are my witness. Yes. Everyone will be questioned. So that's why Holy Prophet is saying, the tongue, it will bring you to a hellfire. Today's people, mashallah, they are eating fire 24 hours a day. As soon as they open their mouth, they start talking. Nonsense. Garbage. Has nothing passing near to Islam. But that's how unbelievers they put. They have seen it in some movies. They watch through the internet, some clips, some this, some that. Movies, they're making movies now. Watching some time to time, how much they're destroying, how much they are putting fitna into Islam under the name of Islam. I'm watching the movies that they are making under the name of Islam, that they are saying that they are supporting Islam. I watched a couple of Turkish movies, just their clips. Five minaret, this, that, I'm watching the movie Takwa, movies. This is supposed to be the movies that is making religion up. But I'm watching how much fitna and confusion they are putting inside. You remember when I was in 39th Street and they came to me one time, they wanted me to play in the movie. You remember? They make that movie now. They put another character, person, using me. And watch that movie. Yes. So much confusion. How do you know? You go according to your feelings. You have left your intelligence into the hands of your feelings. Your faith is not carrying your intelligence. The faith is something else. Intelligence is something else. How are you coming to decisions? How are you coming to things to say this is right and this is wrong? Through your intelligence. You are not a person that his heart is open and you go according to that. You go according to your intelligence. As Holy Prophet is saying, when it's coming those days, and Dajjal is going to come to you, and he's going to show you things. He's going to show you Jannah and Jahannam. I'm sleeping over there. See? Yeah, so much important. Dajjal is going to come to you. He's going to show you Jannah and Jahannam. How you will save yourself from that. Oh, now everywhere I'm sitting, you're going to read Suratul Kaf. Everyone's saying this. Memorize this and read. And it's said, finish. Where, if you memorize the whole Quran, so many people, they're memorizing the whole Quran, but they are bounding into Jahannam. So many did. Do you think that just with the words, with kaflet, you're going to reach, you're going to see, you're going to escape from the hand of that Dajjal? Because your mind, you are using your mind again there. It's nothing else. Your faith is not moving. And your mind is in the hand of, is a hostage in the hand of your feelings. And your feelings, it is in the hand, hostage in the hand of your ego. Your ego says to you, you're feeling this way, you are right. How are you coming to that understanding? Where is your balance? How you are putting? Are you thinking that those people that they come and they pass from this world, that they reach to so high stations, they built Islam? Do you think that you are better than those? I tell you a story. Once upon a time, Sultan Süleyman Han, Sultan Süleyman the Magnificent, he was traveling somewhere, going to a war, and they built the tents. Building tent to a sultan, don't think building tent like this in 1 hour time. It has so much detailed work to do. Hundreds of camels, they are carrying everything. And they built a tent to the area. And after finish, Sultan is entering inside. He's finding on the middle pole that holding the whole tent up. At the end, it's kind of end that they start eating the wood. And they came over there and they start eating the wood. So if they eat that tent, that pole, center pole, the whole tent is going to collapse in short time. And Sultan Süleyman, he is going to a war, saying what we're going to do with this ends now. And he is writing a letter to a Shaykhul Islam that he's already in Istanbul, sending top speed his messengers, saying go to Shaykhul Islam and he should give fatwa. What should I do? Should I break? Should I kill the ants? Do I have the right to kill the ants? Are you understanding? Are you understanding the meaning of this? Or are you just heedlessly in gaflet, looking like lolos? Are you understanding what you are talking daily in your life? And are you understanding what is the Sultan is doing? Are you understanding? Are you comparing yourself to that? Compare yourself to that. Compare yourself to that. That every day how many decisions you are making in your life that it is wrong. And compare yourself to that Sultan that you already reach, and he is a Halifa of Allah. He is an Evliya and he is hesitating to kill, to give order to kill the ants, and saying we should consult with the Shaykhul Islam, because Shaykhul Islams are the one who's going to give correct fatwa, and sending the messenger. And Shaykhul Islam sending message back to Sultan, saying to him, O Sultan, the great Sultan, if you like, you can break the ant, you can destroy them. But don't forget, in the judgment day, the ants, they're going to complain about you and they're going to take their right from you. Says, it's up to you. You are Sultan. You can make any decision. If you want, destroy them. And what Sultan did? Saying, no, I cannot go under that burden. I will not go in the judgment place with this burden. For that reason, remove the tents. We're going to another place. Don't bother the ants. Good morning, America. Good morning, Muslims. Good morning, people who's making fatwa 24 hours a day to themselves and to others. Good morning. Welcome to this real world. The real Islam. That is Islam, and that's how Islam is. And always is going to stay that way. If you move yourself out from that, you are out of Islam. You are not in Islam. You are out of Islam. And Sultan Süleyman the Magnificent, he passes away from this world when he is over 83 years of age, on the horse, running for the sake of Allah, to build the religion of Allah, to bring the flag of Prophet alayhi wasalam far as distant. This is what they were running. They didn't run to get countries. They didn't run to get wealth. They ran to bring the religion of Allah far distance, that where the kufr, to bring down kufr. And he passed away. And they brought his body back to Istanbul. And 500 muezzin. 500 muezzin, they are making his janazah prayer. Meaning 500 muezzin is one is saying here, the other one all the way on behind saying, Allahu Akbar, taking takbir, Allahu Akbar. For the people to reach Istanbul, that time Istanbul, where the Süleymaniye is, is reaching all the way to the other side of the Fatih, and thousands, hundreds of thousands of people, they are in the Sultan's janazah prayer. And when they're going to, they bury Sultan, they put him in the ground, and Sadrazam came with a big box and saying, this is the last wishes of our Sultan, and he's saying when he die and he will be buried, this box should be buried with him. The Sheikhul Islam's there, they say no. Even if he's Sultan, cannot take anything worldly from this world to the grave. This box is worldly. As a worldly value, should not go into the grave. Saying this is the wish of Sultan, saying doesn't matter. Sheikhul Islam, they are saying doesn't matter. Only way that we will bury this with Sultan, we have to open the box to see what is inside. And Sheikhul Islam, Ebu Suud Efendi, who became Sheikhul Islam to so many sultans, he gave fatwa, jurisdictions. They open the box and he find all the fatwas that Sultan Süleyman asked him, and he given his signatures in it. And he start crying, Şeyhül İslam crying, the skies can crack, skies can collapse. Saying, oh great Sultan, you save yourself in the judgment day, in the questioning with my fatwas. What I'm going to do when I'm going to enter the grave? These are the people that they live Islam perfect, 100%. These are the people that they are the evliya of Allah. And this is how much they were shaking. Today's people, they don't know how to make wudu 24 hours a day, making fetva. Tuh, yazıklar olsun size. Yazık, yazık. You're just burning your own self, nothing else. Nothing else. So, the life is yours. You can live as you like. You can put yourself any side you want. If you're thinking that you're just going to say, I'm a nice person, I'm in safety, continue that way. Don't forget what the Sheikhul Islam did and Sultans of Halifas did. Keep remembering this. And do whatever you want after that. You don't have to bother yourself with anything. Either to say to yourself, maybe they are crazy. Maybe I know better. You can fool yourself that way too if you want. Every door is open to you. Which already so many Turks today, they are making bad movie about Sultan Süleyman. And so many is accepting for that movie to be run. Okay. It's okay. The hak and batıl is going to be separate, yes. The one who's accepting that movie, their heart how it is, and the one who's not accepting hak and batıl is going to be separated. It's the time. So welcome to you. Look which side you are falling into. It is in your hand. Don't blame nobody except yourself. You by yourself. If you don't know any better, then you have to consult. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying. Consult with those. And he's telling you who are those. Find those and consult and go according to that. Otherwise, say, I am an individual. I read a lot. I have so many diplomas. I have so much money. I am a businessman. I am a mafia man. I am a king. I am a sultan. Say whatever you want and go according to that. But it's not going to be that way in the grave. Believe me. If you don't believe me, you don't have to believe me. You're going to experience it. You're going to see it. You're going to fall in it. You cannot escape from it. Impossible. Not you, not me, nothing. You cannot escape from it. And don't say today, including myself, I am good today. You may be good today. You don't know what is waiting for you for tomorrow. Prepare yourself for the tricks and the traps of shaitan for tomorrow. And if you don't have sheikh, definitely you're going to fall double tomorrow to the hand of shaitan again. If you don't have, we have a sheikh. Not to say, I have a sheikh, and what the sheikh says to you, to go and to do otherwise. Not to say, have a sheikh, just to go visiting my vacation once a day, week, one time, 5 minutes, and later go do whatever you want. You don't have a sheikh. You're just consulting with your own ego, everything. And you're responsible from that. Nobody else. I mean, Allah Ta'ala, Fatiha. Yes, definitely the West and the Westerners and the Easterners and the East, they never want to hear such a things like this anymore. Say, we are intelligent people. What did they, what else they say in this school? Self-esteem. Have self-esteem. You don't have your own mind, you are asking to somebody else, Ali. Why are you going and asking? You need Sheikh Ali? You don't know how to pray in Islam? Why is that? Why you have to go? Are you crazy? Your mind is not, cannot carry you? You cannot do anything? Yes. Sometimes. When you come to the fork, make decision. The road comes to fork always. Okay. We enter to this road with the Sheikh. Sheikh is not moving so fast. So we already know the road. Let's move fast. We run. They run. Now you come to the fork. Make a decision. Well, I think he's right. Go to right. You're not going to see sign there to say to you, this is a wrong road. Then you're going to come to another fork. It's double there again or triple. Three roads. Which one you're going to enter? If you don't have a vision, as Holy Prophet saying, alayhi salatu wasalam, if Allah did not give you that secret, which transmitting from Prophet to those ones that they are the guide of the Ummat, if you don't have that, and you know by yourself to have that or not, you know it. If you don't have that, don't enter in that fork. You're going to come to the wrong road. And you're going to think that that is the right road, and more wrong, more wrong, more wrong, until the end, you're not going to accept anything. In the end, you're going to see the door bringing you to fire because you enter to the wrong roads. You cannot make this journey without a guide. The Holy Prophet is leading in the front, and all those that the Holy Prophet والسلام, has given permission, they are leading the nations to that direction. They don't hesitate. They know when they come to the fork, before the fork, say, you gotta take the left road, not right side, because they see the sign openly. And those ones are the one who's sitting in the Prophet's divine presence every night. Other than that, you cannot lead the nation. If you are there, then you know each other too. You know who's sitting in that council of the Prophet ﷺ. And if you are there, you don't find disagreement with each other. Because one of them is leading the nation of Muhammad from east to west. One is leading from west to east. One is leading from north to south. One is leading from south to north. You don't interfere to the business of that one who is leading from west to east. He is going to take different road. The one who's leading them from east to west, he is going to take different road. So if you are one of those, definitely you are not fighting and arguing. If you are not, you're finding yourself into different sides. And that's what is happening. That's what has happened to this nation. And billions are ready to dive inside the fire. Ready. They all standing on the line, ready to jump inside the fire, thinking that they're going to fly. Okay, welcome. There's nothing anybody can do to anybody. You choose your own self by yourself. Nobody is choosing for you. By yourself, by your own self. That's why you are responsible. Allah has given to you intelligence. Intelligence, you have to use it until you go and you found your Sheikh. When you found your Sheikh, you have to give that up there. You have to take the paper, clean paper, giving it to your Sheikh, and the pen saying, as you like, make any road for me, I have to follow. This is it. Otherwise, come and go. It's It's okay. When you're going to come to the fork, you're going to have to make your own decision. And as I say, you're going to make the wrong decision. Because Shaitan is waiting in every corner to whisper to you. Too many Shaitans. Don't think that the Shaitan is coming to you, ugly creature. It's coming to you from the side of Hakton Turi. Ve min Allah'u tevfik el Fatiha. Evet. Evet. Your sweets and your tea and your coffee. Aman ya Rabbi. Estağfurullah ya Rabbi. Aman ya Rabbi. Aman ya Rabbi. Evet. Ne diyor orada? Aç sesini ve söyle oku. Şimdi sen ismi söylemedin. Birisi vardı.
We have a question from a viewer asking, he likes to be with Sheikh Efendi, but his ego is keeping him away. He wants help.
His ego is keeping him away.
His shaitan. He should leave his shaitan. Duyuluyor mu? Are you the servant of your ego? Or you are the servant of your Lord? If you want to be the servant of your Lord, you have to run to do the opposite what your ego is saying. If you knowing that your ego is keeping you away now, and you are not wanting to participate in any way, in the way of Allah and His Prophet, and you know that your ego is fooling you, if the angel of death is coming to you now, you are in trouble. Who give you guarantee that you're going to reach by tomorrow? Your ego making big plans to you. Who is guaranteeing you that you're going to reach by tomorrow? Nobody. So what's stopping you? The world, dunya, and what else? What the Shaykh is asking from you? Nothing. He's asking you to be a better servant to your Lord and to take the control of your ego under your hand. That's what the Shaykh is going to teach you. Not to be a slave to your ego, but to have the ego under your control. As majority, billions, world reached to 7 billion, it's ready to be destroyed. Maybe 6 billion is going because of their ego. It's nothing else. If they are running to be a servant of Allah, you think Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will let them to go? One of his servants, he will burn the whole world for it. Those one servant, Nuh alayhi salam, he went back and forth asking to those nations, saying to them, turn back around. The lifestyle that you're living is according to your ego. Your Lord doesn't like it. Turn around. And he went to them 600 years. Every time they hit him, they kick him, they spitted on him, they damaged him. He went, he got cured, he came back to them again. He didn't give up. He didn't give up until one day he reached to that station saying, Ya Rabbi, don't leave one believer, one individual on the face of earth who's not accepting you and living according to their ego. As soon as he opened his hand, Allah said, I accepted it. Built the ship. And it took so many years to build the ship. And Nuh Aleyhisselam, knowing what he asked from Allah, and knowing that all those people who's going to be against, they're going to be punished. And continue going and saying to them, saying, don't be crazy. Stop, turn around. I know what I ask, and Allah accepted it. And punishment is coming to you. Turn around. It's not for me, it's for you. They continue with the same arrogance. What was making them? Their ego. Until they have burned in that flood. Don't think that that flood was just a normal water, which is preparing to come now too. They burn and disappear in that flood. And who lost? Themselves. All they had to do to step on their ego to enter to the ship to find safety. They didn't. Their ego didn't let them. Because they didn't want to put authority on their ego. So if you want to continue that way, welcome to you too, whoever. Doesn't matter. We are saying this for our own self, for our own family members, for the whole world. If the man doesn't want to do anything and he wants to move according to his ego, you cannot do anything to him. You can have all the cigarettes in your hand, you cannot do anything to him. The Abu Jahl didn't want to change. He was following his ego. Holy Prophet went to him so many times. He didn't change. He continued with his ego, saying he supported his ego, and his ego bring end to him to Jahannam. Those that they give up from their ego, they submit themselves to the Prophet, alayhi wasalam. They live in dunya, correct individuals. They reach to the highest station in dunya. They reach to the highest station in Ahirat. Their name is known 1400 years. Their name is riding with the golden alphabet everywhere. The believers and unbelievers, they have to know their name. They mentioning their name. In libraries of America, go finding. Found so many Sahabi's name. Watch. Everywhere, in every book. Who are those Sahabis, you think? Once upon a time, they were just slaves. They were just poor people that nobody knew about them. They were lost in that crowd. They accepted the Prophet. They accepted the message what Prophet brought. And the message was saying, step on your ego and say, La ilaha illallah. You cannot say, La ilaha illallah, correctly if you are living with your ego. You didn't understand the meaning of the La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. La ilaha illallah, it is a sword against your ego. As Holy Prophet saying, we coming. He came from the war, and he said, now we're turning from a small jihad to greater jihad. So, Ya Rasulallah, so many wealth is gone, so many people are wounded, so many people are killed. Is it any greater war than this? He said to them, yes. The war that you're going to make against your ego, that is the war that we're really looking. Because this war, he says, so many times, once in your lifetime, so many people is going to come to the earth, they never going to enter to that war. Did you enter to that war? Did you ever enter to a war? No. What is the meaning of war? You don't know nothing. He says the greater jihad is that you're going to make war with your own ego. Your own ego is going to attack you all the time, and you're going to fight back. Only way to fight back to your ego, you need help, you need ammunition, you need bullets, you need gun to fight back to your ego. If you don't have the ammunition, you have the gun, you cannot fight with the enemy. And they say to those evliya, what is this sohbet? Says, my son, this sohbet is like ammunition to the soldiers. The soldiers, they don't have ammunition. If they have the gun in their hand, they are no good for nothing. The sohbet is good for you to fight back to your ego. Fight back to Shaitan. If you take an upright. And if you come, welcome. It's a one your ego. If you don't want to come to praise your ego a little bit more, it's okay. But don't forget, Azrael is very close to you. Don't forget that. Not only to you, to me too, to everyone. It's very close to those ones. That they are running to support their ego. Running to support their world. Amen. This much should be enough for that one who's asking the question and to everyone. Any other question? No. This much enough for everybody. Selamu Aleyküm. Rahmetullah, Berekatuh. Inshallah, if we are alive and healthy by tomorrow, noontime also, we will have another Turkish sohbet. If we are, as I say, if we go to sleep tonight, and if we get up by tomorrow. And if we are healthy, inshallah. Fatiha. Amin. Selamu aleyküm. Rahmetullah. Allah ya Kerim.